Greetings citizen, and welcome back for some more This Week in Star Citizen. Grab your popcorn, and let's dive in. Be my Valentine card contest. There were a ton of really cool entries, but CIG picked a winner for the Valentine's Day card contest, with first place going to Frapwam, who wins a Banu Defender with LTI. Nice one sir, great work. Valentine's Day Screenshot Contest. Sticking with contests, the winners for the screenshot contest were also announced. The first place prize of a Super Hornet Heartseeker with LTI goes to Dr. Diddy with this great shot of a purple heart. Very cool. CIG Crytek lawsuit. The ongoing legal saga between CIG and Crytek may have just come to an end. A settlement has apparently been reached, but no specific details have been released. However, both parties have allegedly filed for the case to be dismissed. Let's hope so. Inside Star Citizen. Following on from last week's awesome episode of Inside Star Citizen, we joined the old disco beard for a look at the progress on Microtech's three moons, Calliope, Clio, and Utopi, and it has to be said, they are looking epic. One of them has no ocean, the other has a frozen one, and the last has a liquid ocean. And it looks like the big cheese has given them the go for launch, so we'll hopefully be seeing them in 3.9 sometime next month. Or something. Anyway, great work guys and gals. Now, CIG, Gibboat. And next, after much anticipation, old Huckle's Muck Disco Beard takes us on a room-by-room tour of his favorite ship in the whole verse. I shall now hush my big fat mouth, and just let these images speak for themselves, because they are pretty good. Overall this was another great episode of Inside Star Citizen with some really nice info. So thanks again Jared, and although you do in fact rock, this man right here. Anyway, sticking with the Carrack, there was an update to the PTU which saw the Carrack added, but only spawnable by the developers. So no Gibbening. There was salt. Then, late Friday, another patch hit the PTU and this time there was no Carrack disclaimer in the patch notes. Hype was bigly. But CIG only gib Carrack to Avocado. There was much salt in Spectrum. Salt was everywhere. It was truly an avalanche of salt. Then, inexplicably, Saturday saw a post from CIG saying the Carrack was now available to all in the PTU. There was much rejoicing.
Oh my god! Okay, it's happening! Everybody stay calm!
What's the procedure?
Stay calm!
And cries of Gibbening could be heard from the moon. But alas, it turns out that anyone who had upgraded their C8 Pisces to the C8X, which turns out to be practically everyone, could not spawn Carrack. Yep, you guessed it, more salt. Lots of salt. Tremendous, bigly salt. Nobody has ever seen salt like this. So, there you have it, another triumph of CIG marketing and hype. But as you can see, Always Pig was eventually able to get his hands on the Carrack, and enjoyed flying around in it for all of, about 12 minutes, before it randomly ejected me into the void for reasons. Anyway, I shall be doing a somewhat more in-depth review once it has stopped trying to kill me. Stay tuned. Star Citizen Live. In SCL this week El Capitan Disco Beardo is joined by Yogi Klatt and Richard Tyler, who answer a shedload of questions regarding the Vehicle Experience Program. Lots of interesting questions presented by the community and the guys did their best to answer them all. Not really much to complain about here, go check it out, link in the description below. Galactic Guide to the Kano System. Discovered by Tabitha Caster in 2463 from the comfort of her living room couch, the Caster system consists of a central G-type main sequence star, four wholly unremarkable planets, a few human settlements, and sentient bacteria. Go check out the article, link in description below. Roadmap Roundup. Finally, after decades of waiting, Alpha 4.1 has been added to the roadmap. Sweet. Let's have a quick gander. Well, this is looking a little sparse. Maybe there's some really juicy tidbits inside. Let's see now. Realistic weapon handling. Ship AI hazard avoidance. Some FPS polish. Oh wait, here we go. This is the good shit right here. Improved throw. At long fucking last, forget the bloody Carrack. This right here has to be the most hotly anticipated thing in the game so far. I'm actually amazed we've all managed to stay interested in this project without it. Moving on. Object push and pull. This is actually going to be pretty useful. Useful for pushing shit out the way, like, oh I don't know, a random fucking constellation that spawns in your habanero 18. Missile operator mode. Again. This might be pretty useful, especially for ships like the Vanguard and the Connie. Mercury Star Runner. Nice. Looking forward to this one. Grey Cat Multi-Tool Cutting Attachment. Will allow for freeform cutting. Excellent. We'll finally be able to draw massive penises on things. And finally the GP33 Grenade Launcher. Perfect for lobbing utterly fucking useless grenades even further than you can toss them. Outstanding. Well, I have to say, it's looking a little anemic. And no sign of 4.2. Maybe that should have been the last entry on the 4.1 column. Add 4.2 to the roadmap. Hey ho. Right, well that's about it for me for this week. As always, thank you all for watching. Now, commence like button slapping and subscribing. Do it now.